things you do.
You got your stuff on, Aaron. Working on it.
Okay.
Would you like to do monsters?
Yeah, we're going to do monsters. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, from the entrance of the monsters?
All the way.
Yeah.
So in this scene, while they're getting set up, this is actually a little earlier in the play. We see Pinta's family. And they're severely dysfunctional. Both parents are alcoholics. And at one point, they're having a party, and Pinta's at the party causing a disturbance. And they don't wander there. Their friends are over, they're drinking, they're dancing, they're having a good time. And at one point, Pinta is so frustrated that she cannot get her parents' attention. She starts doing things that severely interfere with the partying. And in the world of this play, which is not necessarily naturalism or realism, at one point, the mother, who's on stilts, and we do this for a lot of symbolic reasons, but the mother lifts her skirt and releases a torrent of monsters to scare the hell out of her daughter, so she'll leave them alone. And so we're going to pick it up just about that point, correct?
Yes.
Why the mother is on stilts, the father is also on stilts, we'll leave that to your imagination. I'm not going to give it a long...
It's all about scale.
So, whenever we're ready, we'll pick it up here.
Well, it's also based on that idea, like, when we're little, everything seems so much bigger to us.
Right.
And if you've ever had the experience of, like, visiting a house you used to live in when you were really little, and all of a sudden the house is so much smaller than you remember it being, it's because you were actually really tiny. So, Jose and I were talking about how we can play with the idea of scale, sticking to the, you know, magical realism, which is how he writes, that in her memory, her parents are really tall. So we stuck him on stilts, because it helps.
Do you want to go, ding, da dink.
Yeah.
Ding, ding. I need a moment to find that ding, ding.
Thank you.
Side note, go up to that middle panel, because you'll take off your stuff and throw it off to the side and then roll back in. Sorry.
Taking care of choreography.
Kind of a mall?
Kind of my job. Yes.
Trio?
We're going to do the Carnival Mall.
Okay.
From the entrance, like when when you first walk in through the spinny door thing.
Yeah.
So this scene is a continuation of the scene we saw with the three of them. The pimp, after he gets Pinta to sort of become his friend and eventually his girlfriend, takes her to a mall where she's allowed to shop and buy, and it's a whole land. The playwright calls it this land of consumption. So once they get set up, we'll show you the Carnival Mall scene.
Would escape to the edge of town to quiet the fears in my head.
No, no, this one.
The Drop King.
Oh shoot, I wish we had some shoes on.
She has shoes hanging from this. Obviously not right now.
There will be shoes hanging from the pole. She's the shoe lady at the mall.
There was some coercion involved.
I like my job. Everybody ready? Josh Brown, you ready? Hello?
Yeah, ready.
Okay, that was convincing, man. Here we go.